Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to create a React app and add the sidebar component to it. The React sidebar component is a responsive, expandable, and collapsible container area that holds primary and secondary information placed alongside the main content of a web page. In this video, you will learn how to configure the sidebar component and some of its built-in features, toggling, configuring the doc state, changing sidebar types, and integrating the sidebar with other components. Before proceeding, make sure you have installed the latest versions of Node.js and React. I'll be using Visual Studio Code as my editor and showing the output in the Chrome browser. First, I open Visual Studio Code and create a new application using the command npx create React app. I provide the app name, my React app. Since I want to create the app with TypeScript, I add the template TypeScript. It will take a few seconds to create the project. Next, I navigate to the newly created React app. To use the sidebar component, I type the npm install at Syncfusion / EJ2 React Navigations --- save command. Now, the package will be installed. Before using a Syncfusion component, I need to register the trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. For instructions on how to generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. Since the 2022 Volume 1 release, the Syncfusion React license key registration is mandatory. Next, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. I import the sidebar component from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Navigations package. Then, I add few division and span elements with a header and main content. Within this division element, I add the sidebar component tag and set the width to 250 pixels. I add the division element as a child element with the class name sidebar content. I add the content as sidebar content inside that element. Next, let me define CSS for the sidebar. Open this app.css file and import the material theme. I have applied CSS attributes such as background, line height, font size, text align, padding, and color to ensure proper alignment and styling for the header, main content, and sidebar component. Now, let me save the changes and run the application using the npm start command. You can see the web page with a header, main content, and the sidebar. By default, the sidebar component is positioned on the left side of the page. To place the sidebar on the right, I add the position property and set its value to right. Now, the sidebar is on the right side of the main content. By default, the sidebar will not close if you click the web page. To change this, I set the property close on document click and set its value to true. See, when I click on the document, the sidebar closes. You can open and close the sidebar using the button also. First, I need to install the Syncfusion React button package using the command npm install at Syncfusion / EJ2 React buttons --> save. After that, I import the button component from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Buttons package.
I add the span element with the inline style float left.
Inside this, I add the button component tag with the class name custom button. To set a menu icon for the button component, I add the icon CSS property and set the class to eIcons and eMenu. I change the position of the sidebar component to the left. I also import the CSS reference for the button component and define the color, font size, background color, and border color CSS styles to align the button.
The menu button has been added to the left corner of the page.
Next, I will demonstrate how to open and hide the sidebar component using the button I just added.
To do that, first I remove the close on document click property, and I add the on click event with the appropriate callback method, button click. Then, I define this button click method. To access the built-in methods of the sidebar, I declare an instance of the sidebar component and reference this object inside the sidebar component.
Inside the button click method, I call the toggle method to toggle the sidebar. Now, clicking the menu button closes the sidebar component.
To display it again, I simply click the menu button. Next, I will show you how to replace the sidebar content with the list view component.
To use the list view component, first, I need to install the Syncfusion React Lists package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2react-lists --save.
I import the list view component from the ej2react-lists package.
Then, I add the list data object with a fields ID, text, and description.
I include the list view component tag.
I assign the list data object to the data source property of the list view component and map the data source fields to the list view using the fields property.
To learn more about integrating the list view component in a React application,
please check the Getting Started video linked in the card above and the description below. Since I am displaying the programming language in the sidebar content, I set the button content as language and modified the main content based on the programming language.
In the app CSS file, I add CSS reference for list view component.
Remove the padding top CSS style and change the text align to left for the sidebar content. You can see that the list is integrated into the sidebar, and the main content has changed. I need to change the main content based on the list item clicked.
To do that, I add the select event with an appropriate callback method, onSelect, to the list view component.
I declare this method. Then, I define the variable description and its setter function setDescription using the useState hook with the appropriate value.
Inside this onSelect method, I include the code to change the main content description using the useState hook.
I also change the main content value as description. When I click the languages, the sidebar's descriptions will change in the main content. By default, when the sidebar is collapsed, its list view items are hidden.
To partially display these list items, I add the enableDoc property and set its value to true. Then, I set the doc size to 72 pixels.
While the sidebar is collapsed, the list view items are now partially visible.
Notice that, by default, the sidebar expanding type is auto. The sidebar component's other expanding options are over, push, and slide.
I'll remove the doc state properties to explain the types clearly. To expand the sidebar using the over option, I add the type property
and set its value to over.
Now, you can see the sidebar floats over the main content.
Next, I change the type to push. Now, the sidebar pushes the main content area so they appear side by side, and shrinks the main content within the screen width. If I change the type to slide, the sidebar translates the X and Y positions of the main content based on the sidebar width. By default, you can interact with the main content. To disable this, I add the property show backdrop and set its value to true. See now, you cannot interact with the main content. In this video, I have shown you how to add the sidebar component to a React application. I also showed you how to use a few of its basic features. If you would like to try out the example used in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React suite through our community license if you are eligible. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.